A Philippine senator wants to bring back the death penalty for police officials involved in the illegal drug trade. Senator Bong Revilla floated that possibility as the Senate panel on public order and dangerous drugs resumes its probe on the alleged cover-up in a 6.7 billion peso drug haul last year. The proposal was supported by former Philippine Police Chief and now Senator Ronald De La Rosa.
Kailangan na ba na ibalik ang bitay para mapatino natin ang mga ito? When the people ought to enforce the law are the very ones who break it, shouldn't the gavel fall hardest on them? Kaya lumalakas ang loob ng mga maliliit na kriminal at iba pang masasamang loob ay dahil sa mga kagaya nitong mga sangkot na pulis na ito na sa kabila ng labis na kabulukan ay patuloy pa rin nakakatakas sa pangil ng batas.
The National Police Commission, meanwhile, refused to name the four high-ranking police officers who were linked to the drug trade after a sweeping review. The NAPOLCOM says it is still building up cases against them. The Senate begins tackling the proposed reforms on the military pension system, which fiscal managers describe as a huge drain on the national budget. Ara Perez has the story.
There is an increase in the number of personnel who avail of retirement every time there are discussions on pension reforms for uniformed personnel. This was revealed by the Philippine National Police during the Senate hearing on the proposed reforms in the pension system for military and uniformed personnel, or MUPs.
From 2018 to 2022, there were a total of 18,000 who retired. Out of this,
optional retirement.
Yes, sir. Retirees sir, both compulsory and retirement.
Out retirable of that, because of age.
Yes, right. Sir. Both, sir. Out of these 18,000, sir, 12,000 availed the optional retirement, sir.
What?
Yes, sir. 12,000, sir.
That's
65%, sir. It's only, maybe we can display the...
Because of this pension only?
Most probably, sir, there's a correlation between these laws, sir.
The Bureau of Treasury wants MUPs to start receiving their pension only when they reach 57 years old. While Senate Bill No. 284 is designating a 30-year service for voluntary or optional retirement, higher than the existing 20 years of service. The AFP agrees with raising the optional retirement to 25 to 30 years of service. DND Officer in Charge Carlito Galvez Jr. said soldiers appear to be consciously making an effort to do this, as seen in the decrease of the number of retirees in previous years. He said from the 138,000 retirees in 2021, this has gone down to 136,000 in 2022 and 134,000 in March 2023.
Meaning, mukhang nababawasan natin yung mga nag-optional retirement at talagang nakita natin dahil nagdoble po yung, ano, yung sweldo ng mga sundalo, minarapat na nila na mas maganda na ma-maintain na nila yung kanilang status as soldiers na itagpos na po nila hanggang sa compulsory retirement nila. Medyo mahirap sa kasi sa optional retirement, hindi natin na po program. Kasi yung optional retirement is only ano, yun ang medyo ano, decision ng sundalo yun eh. So yun din ang medyo mahirap kasi yung variable, pagka once hindi natin na-determine, predetermine, hindi natin na napoforecast, kunyari for example, ngayong year na malalaman nila na babaguhin yung law, maybe marami po mag-optional retirement ngayong year or next year.
The Bureau of Treasury also wants to remove the existing policy of automatic promotion for MUPs when they retire.
Ang proposal po namin na if they retire at the current rank po nila.
Parang premyo yan sa isang nag-retire eh, na one rank higher in terms of pension. Parang nga, nagpasalamat ang gobyerno sa kanila, sa kanilang servisyo na ginawa at nakarating sila sa panahon na yan ng retirement na hindi sila namatay.
Senator De La Rosa pointed out finance managers should use updated data upon seeing that the data used were from 2020 to identify the 9.6 trillion peso unfunded liabilities of the MUP pension system, which comprise 53.4% of the GDP.
Di para bang pinapalabas natin dito na yung MUP ang dahilan bakit magkakaroon din ng fiscal collapse. please, ituloy natin ito. Let's not do misrepresentation, sir. Let's not paint a very grim picture para mapapasama yung ating mga military and uniform personnel.
Ang sinasabi lang po natin, kung hindi po tayo a-action ngayon, palaki po ng palaki yung pong pensyon na kinakain ng budget. Hindi lang po kami na-alarma na dumalaki ang binabayad sa pensyon, mas na-alarma po kami na yung pong pensyon mas malaki pa po sa ginagastos natin para sa MOE, ng capital outlay ng ating for defense.
Finance managers earlier explained that the national government solely funds the pension of military and uniformed personnel because the MUPs do not pay for contribution, unlike other government employees. Although the Bureau of Treasury favors reforms to be applied to active personnel and new entrants, the proposed legislation only applies to new entrants or those who will become members of the MUP before its effectivity into law. Mandatory contribution will also be imposed. But for Senator Bongo, finance managers should just look for other sources of funding.
Ibahin po natin ang pagkonsidera sa kanila. May exemption naman po dahil sa totoo lang po, iba po ang trabaho nila. Buhay po ang tinatayang nila para mapanatili ang seguridad ng ating bansa. Konsuelo na po sana sa ating military at uniform personnel.
Galvez appeals for a middle ground, while Defense Committee Chairperson Jinggoy Estrada said they will not rush discussions on reforms in the pension system.
The DND and DAP respectfully appeals that the morale and welfare of our soldiers be given due weight. Mere discussions of proposals relating to retirement benefits has already affected the morale and caused uneasiness not only from within the active ranks of the armed forces but even from our veterans and retirees.
There is no room for mistake here. If this committee commits a mistake, either we go for the MUPs, we go for the government, kailan we have to strike a balance, kailan acceptable to everybody.
The proposal will be referred to a technical working group and a timetable will be set along with comprehensive studies. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
The Senate has also begun its debates on the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund Bill. The MIF bill seeks to create the country's first sovereign wealth fund and is one of the priority measures of the Marcos administration. Senator Sonny Angara, chairman of the Senate Committee on Finance, sees lengthy debates ahead as senators try to thresh out some of the contentious provisions of the measure.
There'll be on the composition of the board, who can sit, what are the powers, what are the safeguards, what are the accountabilities, what are the penalties, what are the fees, allowable fees. I think there's a current 2%, which... although that is the practice in, I understand, in the industry, it seemed to be a little on the high side, given if you're managing 500 billion in investable funds, 2% of that is quite a sizable amount.
Now, Senator Francis Escudero warns against the reacquisition of government stake in the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines. He says it can be destabilizing and expensive. Escudero also doubts government's capability to run the NGCP, saying the state's failure in the past even led to the privatization of the agency. At least four senators have called for a review of the NGCP franchise, which is 40% owned by Chinese investors. Senator J.V. Hercito asserts governments should have full control of public utilities.
Kung wala sana tayong dispute, China. West Philippine Sea. Pansin nyo lately, medyo aggressive, medyo hostile na itong mga Chinese Coast Guard at Chinese government sa pakikitungo sa atin. Kaya hindi mo maalis sa akin pangamba na pwede tayong makarilisa sa isang pagpindot lamang. Kaya ako po, yung mga utilities tulad ng... National Grid Corporation, ng airport management system, dapat po yan manatili sa ating pong control, lalo na sa Pilipinong korporasyon o entity.
A commission and appointments panel has confirmed the appointment of Rex Gatchalian as Secretary of Social Welfare Department. Now, Ara Perez joins us with the details of this story. Hi, Ara.
Hello, Stanley. The CA plenary will now discuss this later, but during the two-hour committee hearing, Rex Gatchalian has already met with support and advanced congratulations from CA member congressmen and senators. Among the issues that Gatchalian responded to are those pertaining to continuous help for 4Ps beneficiaries and poor families. He said that the SWB will focus on them, along with families in street situations or street dwellers. More social workers will be hired. They will be equipped with body cameras. And the CHR will be allowed to join activities anytime. If from provinces, families are targeted to be sent back home in 14 days. Aside from social protection, the SWD will also put up a database for them through the help of the PSA and LGU. The Chalian believes minimum wage earners should also be assisted, as just one, he says, like calamities, they will return to poverty. He also plans on streamlining and fast-tracking the SWD processes through launching a chatbot to respond to queries on application for help or concerns, along with NGOs and foundations seeking for accreditation, which the agency considers as a force multiplier. Sandy.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Ara. The Philippine House of Representatives approves on third and final reading a measure extending the period of availment of estate tax amnesty until 2025. Now, the bill also extends its coverage to include those who died on or before December 31, 2017 to December 31, 2021. Now, around 1 million families are seen to benefit from the proposed extension. The pandemic prompted Congress to amend the law in June 2021 to provide for a two-year extension up to June 14 this year. House Speaker Martin Romualdez says the payment of estate taxes would not only result in additional tax revenue for government, but in the faster distribution and use of inherited properties like land as well. As Philippine officials head to Kuwait to iron out their labor row, one lawmaker suggests several measures that would help ensure the welfare of Filipino workers in the Gulf state. The chairman of the House Panel on Overseas Workers Affairs says shelters for abused workers should be a non-negotiable item during the talks between Philippine and Kuwaiti officials. Cabayan Representative Ron Salo also proposing so-called proof-of-life measures to protect Filipinos in Kuwait.
One of those, perhaps, is requirement by the employer that they would bring the Filipino worker to the Foreign Recruitment Agency's office or at the Polo's office regularly, perhaps once every quarter or perhaps even a month, every month. This is what we call the proof of life, to make sure that we, even there are no police officers going into the homes of the employers, we're pretty assured that our Filipino workers are really being treated well. There are certain employers who still hold the passport of the household worker. And when in fact the bilateral agreement clearly states that this particular passport is a document of the Philippine government and should not be held by the employer. Perhaps one of the things that I'm seeing there is it could be held by the Philippine Embassy or the Polo.
Kuwait has banned the entry of Filipinos without residency permits, claiming the Philippines violated their labor agreement. It remains unclear, even to Philippine officials, what the violation is.